So I'm technically on a break, so I thought I'd stretch my legs. I don't often do this. In fact, I get down so little you would wonder why I would even try to bother. But it all matters. Never mind the dog and owner relationship that's going on next door, making a little bit of noise there. No, they like to have fun. They play doggy together and fetch together and walk together, and it's gonna be real like having a little kid, but a less serious version of a kid. Baby talk all day long. See, making the bed, cleaning the bed. I sort of reflect on the hanging on side to any parent they want to hang on to their children. And as soon as this dog was here, it's like, you know, you can see that their nature is sort of wanting to look after something is fulfilled. And I was like, every parent who has a hard time breaking off as a parent should always get a pet, because especially a dog, because dogs are like children, except, you know, they're pets. So and they're the kind of thing that is going to be like a child forever, and so it's like always needing to be looked after. So it satisfies the parental need to look after something, you know, rather than selfishly inhibit someone because they want to grow up and move away. They should always get a pet so that they can always look after something without, you know, inhibiting it. I mean, a pet is all about being looked after, and the more attention they get, the better it is. So I think that's like a need that's sort of been fulfilled, and I was like, oh, it's probably what you needed all along. So because, I had a hard time breaking the net. And as soon as I did, it was like a big deal. And people felt as though it was in their right to cancel my opportunities and to keep me, you know, at home, when really all they needed to do is replace with a pet, you know. Not like I haven't needed assistance, but, you know, because that opportunity was broken, it was like, oh, it was like, you know, I just reflect on that and this, and it's like, oh, is that what you needed all along? You needed a pet. And it's like, yeah, I think so. It sort of fulfills their instincts. And unlike everything that they said, it suddenly makes sense, you know, everything that they've said to you and stuff, which has been awkward and out of balance, is like, makes sense when you look at it at a pet and owner perspective. And it's like, that would be like so much better, you know, the more perfect solution to your attitude problem. So, to get a pet and then you can dote on something forever. So that's sort of what I was thinking lately. Oh, I'm just not good at these. I used to get my head on the floor and now it's like, oh, I can't even make it. But it's a nice stretch anyways. I want to get my knees, my head on my knees like I had ages ago. I still need to get my weight down. It hasn't really gone down very far. I feel like it's gone down a bit, but I've still feel I've got like a lot of weight on my body. I need a gym, really, because I went through a large movement of increased carbs, complex carbs, and decrease of exercise and full-bodied exercise. And, you know, as a result, I put on heaps of weight here and there and everywhere. And it's like, oh my gosh, you know, how could I give up, you know, to do something that didn't work me out at all. So I literally did floor biking for like 2 or 3 years. And afterwards, I was like, really obese. And it's like that floor biking did not do anything for a full-bodied workout. So that serves me right, but it doesn't matter. I mean, people have always nagged me to want to put on weight and look like I do now. And I'm like, well, no wonder. I mean, it makes them feel more comfortable. It doesn't make you feel very good, though, because you're not really feeling like you look the same. And you don't really like to look at yourself in the mirror. And you definitely don't like to wear any kinds of clothes. You sort of wear clothes to cover yourself up as opposed to just wear clothes. So it's like, wait, I gotta get the right ones that, you know, look good on a larger person. So, but no, I basically just wear pants and tops anyways, so it's no big deal. I just have a couple of sizes up. And it hasn't crippled me in a dating way, even though I haven't dated for a while, but people give me attention when I'm out and about. So I haven't been out for a couple of years, but when I was active, it was like I didn't feel inhibited. I didn't feel like I couldn't date someone if I didn't want to. I mean, I didn't want to, but I didn't feel like I wasn't charming someone. So just have to wear the right clothes. And I was wearing like prints, wild animal prints at the time. And I was like, I don't feel too bad. I mean, for someone who's put on like heaps of weight. Says the person who hasn't yet bothered to go on a set or a photo shoot where, you know, negative attitudes will probably gobble down your not so great physique right down to the bone. Oh, my voice is coming in, going out. I talk too much. Anyway, I gotta get back to work. With all these stretches done, I just do that to make myself feel a bit better.